Members of the Senate, the Republican caucus has concluded, the Democratic caucus has concluded. The Senate is back in session. A quorum is present. We are at privileges of the floor. Do we have any members wishing to speak under privileges of the floor? If not, I wanted to announce that the Rules Committee has approved the waiving of Joint Rule 62A in order to allow the Banking and Finance Committee to hear on July 9th the following bills: AB 209, AB 601, AB 725, AB 745, AB 764, AB 800, AB 1051, and AB 1200, and to allow the Public Employment and Retirement Committee to hear on July 9th AB 755 without objection. So ordered. Members, under motions and resolutions, Senator Pavley, for what purpose do you rise?
Yes, if appropriate, I'd like you to remove item 125, that Senate Bill 171, from the consent calendar.
So ordered. Senator Cox, for what purpose, sir?
Mr. President, let me just get my glasses out here so I can see the finer print here, sir. At the request of the author, Mr. President, if you'll pull AB 491, which is item number 155, pull that from the special consent calendar, sir.
So ordered. All right. Senator Lowenthal, for what purpose, sir?
At the request of the author to remove AB 752, file item 153 from special consent and place it on the inactive file.
So ordered. Senator Wiggins, for what purpose do you rise, ma'am?
I request that item 123, AB 1510, be removed from the special consent calendar for the purpose of amendments at the request of the author.
So ordered. Thank you, Senator Wiggins. Any other items under motions and resolutions? Any other items under motions and resolutions? Mr. Secretary? Mr. Secretary, do we have any other business before we clear the desk? Senator DuCheney, are there budget bills to take up at this time? All right. Members, We will now recess the regular session and convene the third extraordinary session. We could ask the members to take their desks and for members absent from the chamber to please return immediately to their respective desks. The prayer and the pledge will be deemed complete. I want to recognize Senator Cheney. Senator Cheney, we are in third extraordinary session.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, Mr. President, members. I'd like to move to items 16 through 30. We can start with 16. And
those are Senate bills 40 through 54, Senator Cheney, yes?
Yes.
And that is in order to pass them to the Assembly?
Yes.
Then without objection, we'll ask the Secretary to read the bills.
Senate Bill 40 by Senator DeChaney, an act relating to the Budget Act of 2009. Senate Bill 41 by Senator DeChaney, an act relating to the Budget Act of 2009. Senate Bill 42 by Senator
DeChaney. Without objection, deemed read.
40. That's fine.
Senator DeChaney.
Thank you very much. Mr. President, members, these are Senate bills that we would like to pass to the Assembly in the interest of expediency. So when there are additional trailer issues that need to be taken up with any following budget,
Senator Cheney,
revisions that they would be available to us in the Assembly.
One moment, please. Members, these are significant with respect to our budget process. Again, if we could ask for members to take their seats, absent members to return to the chamber, and for members in the chamber to give their attention to Senator Cheney so that we're all clear on the process. Senator Cheney, thank you. Please repeat.
Thank you very much. These are bills, members, that would be available in the Assembly to be used as budget trailer bills when and if there is agreement on a new budget revision beyond those from last week. We will have a similar number of Assembly bills on our floor by my subsequent motion that will allow both houses to have vehicles available for any budget trailer language necessary. I'd ask for your aye vote.
Discussion, Senator Harmon.
Thank you, Mr. President. We'd request a roll call on this vote when it comes up.
Thank you, Senator Harmon. Further debate or discussion? If not, Senator DeChaney, any close?
No, just ask for an aye vote to move these bills to the Assembly.
Secretary, call the roll.
Onnestad? No. Alquist? Aye. Ashburn? No. Benoit? No. Calderon? Aye. Cedillo? Cogdill? Corbett? Aye. Correa? Cox? No. Denham? No. DeSaunier? Aye. DeChaney? Dutton? No. Flores? Hancock? Aye. Harmon? No. Hollingsworth? No. Huff? No. Kehoe? Aye. Leno? Aye. Liu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Maldonado? Negrete McLeod? Aye. Oropesa? Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Romero? Aye. Runner? No. Smidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg? Aye. Strickland? No. Walters? No. Wiggins? Aye. Wolk? Aye. Wright? Aye. Weiland? No. Yee, aye. DeChaney, aye.
Mr. President. Call the absent members.
Cedillo? Cogdill? Correa? Correa, aye. Flores? Aye. Maldonado, Oropesa.
Call the absent members.
Cedillo, Cogdill, Maldonado, Oropesa.
Ayes 23, noes 13. The measure is passed. Senator DeChaney, it's my understanding that you are asking that we substitute the roll call for items 17 through 30. Is that correct?
That is correct. I would request unanimous consent to substitute the roll call on the on the item 17 through 30.
Without objection, ayes 23, noes 13, item 17 through 30, it is so ordered. And those items are deemed passed.
One subsequent motion.
Senator Duchaney, at your desk.
One more motion, Mr. President. And members, without objection, I'd like to move that Assembly Bills 47 through 56, also in the 3X session, be withdrawn from the Rules Committee and given their second reading upon being withdrawn and placed on the file.
Without objection, so ordered. Senator Romero.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just for purpose of introduction, members, please help me welcome Ruth Medina. She's from my district in El Monte. She's one of the Upward Bound students, and she will be an intern in my office for the next 5 weeks. Help me introduce her to the State Senate.
Thank you, Senator Romero. Members, we will now recess the third extraordinary session and convene the fourth extraordinary session. The prayer and pledge will be deemed complete. There are messages from the governor. Secretary will read.
A proclamation by the governor of the state of California. Whereas on this day, pursuant to Section 10F of Article 4 of the Constitution of the State of California, I have proclaimed a fiscal emergency, and whereas this extraordinary occasion having arisen and now existing, it requires that the legislature of the state of California be convened in an extraordinary session. Now, therefore, I, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Governor of the State of California, by virtue of the power and authority vested in me in accordance with Section 10F of Article 4 of the Constitution of the State of California, do hereby convene the Legislature of the State of California to meet in extraordinary session at Sacramento, California, on the first day of July, 2009, at a time to be determined, to consider and act upon legislation to address the fiscal emergency proclaimed by me this day. I, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Governor of the State of California, hereby identify the nature of this fiscal emergency to be projected budget imbalance and insufficient cash reserves for fiscal year 2009-10 and the projected insufficient cash reserves and potential budgetary deficit in fiscal year 2010-11, which are anticipated to result from the dramatically lower than estimated general fund revenues in fiscal years 2008-09 and 2009-10. In witness whereof, I have hereunto set my hand and cause the great seal of the state of California to be affixed this first day of July 2009. Arnold Schwarzenegger, Governor of California.
Senator Steinberg, you are recognized.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Mr. President. Without objection, I move that the Officers Committee on Rules, the Standing Committees, and the Standing Rules for the 2009-10 regular session shall be deemed the same and exactly the same for the 2009-10. Fourth extraordinary session.
Without objection? Without objection? Motion carries.
Senator
Onestad? Forgive me. Senator Onestad.
Sir, we do have an objection. We have asked in the last 30 days for sunshine on the processes of this Senate. And while we agree with most of the rules, we love our leaders. The fact of the matter is that we cannot, in good conscience, now go ahead and waive the three-day print rule. And therefore, because we have to take this as a package, we have to vote no.
Senator Onestad, do your objections go to the motion of Senator Steinberg or to the adoption of SCR 1, which is anticipated shortly? With Senator Steinberg and Senator Onestad, the question from the presiding officer is whether or not the objection of Senator Onestad goes to the in-print rule, which is contained in SCR 1, which has not yet been taken up. The motion offered by Senator Steinberg is limited to the adoption of standing committees and the standing rules of the 2009-10 regular session being deemed the same for this fourth extraordinary session.
fine. Okay, Mr. President. Mr. President.
Senator Steinberg.
If I may, just a point of clarification, and I may have confused the issue a little bit when I spoke. The standing rules do not include the three-day print rule that Senator Onnestad objected to. That is within the next motion, which is SCR 1. So on this, in terms of the standing rules and establishing the session, if there is no objection, I'd ask for unanimous consent to, in fact, move that the officers, the Committee on Rules, standing committees, and the standing rules, the general rules, for the 9-10 regular session shall be deemed the same for the 9-10 fourth extraordinary session.
Thank you, Senator Steinberg. It's without objection, so ordered. Senator Steinberg.
Thank you, Mr. President. Again, I know there'll be an objection to this, but request unanimous consent to take up SCR 1 without reference to committee, print, or file. Object.
Copies on the member Republican, desk.
Republicans object.
We have an objection.
We'll call for a roll call.
Thank you. Secretary will read.
Senate Concurrent Resolution 1 by Senator Steinberg relative to the joint rules of the 2009-10 fourth extraordinary session.
Further debate or discussion? Call the roll.
Onnestad? No. Ahlquist? Aye. Ashburn? No. Benoit? No. No. Calderon? Aye. Cedillo? Cogdill? Corbett? Aye. Correa? Cox? No. Denham? No. DeSaunier? Aye. DeChaney? Dutton? No. Flores? Aye. Hancock? Aye. Harmon? No. Hollingsworth? No. Huff? No. Kehoe? Aye. Leno? Aye. Liu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Maldonado? Negrete McLeod? Aye. Oropesa? Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Romero? Aye. Runner? No. Smidian? Aye. Steinberg? Strickland? No. Walters? No. Wiggins? Aye. Wolk? Aye. Wright? Aye. Wyland? No. Yee? E-I? DeChaney, aye. Correa, aye.
Mr. President. Call the absent members.
Cedillo, Cogdill, Maldonado, Oropesa, Steinberg. Aye. Steinberg, aye.
Mr. President, ayes 23, noes 13.
Ayes 23, noes 13. The resolution is adopted. Senator Steinberg, unless there is an additional item, we are prepared to recess the fourth extraordinary session and reconvene the regular session. So ordered, is there any business in the regular session remaining, members? Additional business in regular session, members. One moment while we confer with the members. Members, we are in regular session. Question is whether there is additional business in regular session. One moment while the secretary confers with the members. Senator Steinberg, let me confirm. Senator Onnestad, do we have additional business in the regular session? One moment. Senator Pavley, for what purpose do you rise?
For the purpose of a committee announcement, if appropriate.
Proceed.
Yes, Natural Resources and Water will be held in 113, 15 minutes after the adjournment of session.
Thank you, Senator Pavley. Any other business under regular session? Senator McLeod.
Yes, BMP will meet immediately after we close session.
Business and professions immediately upon session.
3091.
In room 3191. Thank you, Senator. If there is no other business, Senator Steinberg, the desk is clear.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Just to announce the schedule for the rest of the week, we will be on the call of pro tem from now through the end of the week. We will have a check-in session tomorrow and Wednesday, a scheduled session Thursday morning at 9 o'clock. Committee work will continue, and we will be in touch with, obviously, all of the membership as events progress this week. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Steinberg. The Senate will be in recess until 3:30, at which time the adjournment motion will be made. We will be on the call of the pro tem for the remainder of the week, check-in session on Tuesday, check-in session on Wednesday, and we will reconvene Thursday at 9 a.m. We are in recess.